Welcome to the 2023 USCA Golf Croquet National Championships being held at the Chesapeake Bay Croquet Club in Hartfield, Virginia. Your tournament director is the USCA President, Damon Bidencope. We are, of course, the official YouTube channel of the United States Croquet Association, which is charged with developing croquet in all its various forms all across the country. Don Oakley has been developing croquet in the U.S. for decades, even though he's from Toronto, Canada, and his croquet store by Oakley Woods can provide everything you need from starting a club to becoming a world champion. The Chesapeake Bay Croquet Club, under Macy White's guidance, is now the largest croquet facility in the world. The drone and all the video footage comes from Brian Hovis. Those eight courts to the right have been established for 4 or 5 years now and are playing beautifully. The 16 newer courts to the left have their first season this year and are playing nicely, but have a little ways to go. And lastly, I need to mention Chris Barley, our other sponsor, going on 2 years now. His assistance is very much appreciated. And now the championship singles final for the 2023 Golf Croquet Nationals. These two have a lock on this event. This is a repeat of the pairing from last year. Matthew won it the previous two times, and Sharif won it the three times before that. They're not letting anybody else play in this sandbox the last 7 or 8 years. A good exercise is to get on the USCA website, go to the croquet section, and click on champions, and you'll get the list of all the champions in U.S. events since the USCA was founded. Oh yeah, and I forgot, Matthew is the reigning world champion in golf croquet. One of the exciting developments in our game is that these two, along with Ben Rothman, Stephen Morgan, and the Maloofs, are the best of the best in American golf croquet. In doubles, Sharif and Matthew got absolutely bludgeoned in game three by Tom Balding and Blake Fields, who are in their mid-20s and approaching 17, respectively. The future is very bright. If the best seem luckier than the rest of us, it's because they make their own luck. black's probably wired from yellow, so all he can do is try to score the hoop with an in off. Red's pretty far away for set up first and clear second, so he'll shoot with both balls at black. But only if he needs to. This is why these guys set up so deep. The blue, for instance. There's not much Sharif can do about this blue ball, except maybe try to cut it over where it doesn't have a decent hoop shot. He certainly can't protect red. And from back here, black isn't really blocking anything. Blue will be rolling so hard when it gets there. If he hits it center ball, it'll pull itself right through the hoop. So no need for a jump shot. And all that obviously because black came in from the non-playing side and is not in scoring position. Otherwise, he would just rush peel it. This is incredible. He was trying to clear it, but he'll take the block. What the heck? Notice here how Matthew doesn't stalk at all. This is not recommended for beginners. Ben Rothman and Reg Bamford both stalk religiously. Matthew doesn't need to most of the time. Maybe he should have that time. Macy White out to referee. Macy, of course, is the owner and developer of this fabulous complex. He is usually pretty competitive in the Nationals, but I don't think he's playing in this one. Looks like he's functioning as tournament referee, or at least one of the tournament referees. That's just Brian Hovis, your videographer, making his presence known. So Matthew can't score black without committing a fault by hitting it with a beveled edge. A ball that goes offsides off an opponent ball is legally offsides, and five is the next hoop. And even though Blue's a long way away, he's betting that Sharif isn't going to risk waiting with those two balls in such great hoop shooting position for Black to come back. I don't know that he meant to do that. But we need a name for that. It's a forced snuggle of red on yellow. An arranged marriage. Okay, so now if Sharif wants to make black come back, he'd have to put red in the jaws. Black would then clear yellow. Blue would clear red out of the hoop, and we'd start all over again. So he's going to get on with it. And this is why Matthew did that with black. Ooh, missed opportunity, big time. So he missed the easy one. Let's see if he can do it the hard way. Oh, goody. Here comes a Barnes Wallace over the peg into hoop six. There's a video of Ben Rothman doing this successfully floating around YouTube. It's not crazy. So close. That would have made every croquet highlight reel. While Sharif is sizing things up, let's speculate a little bit. Nobody bothers to measure critical distance, the distance at which a given player will make about half of his roquets. I could probably do it by analyzing these videos, but I'm not going to. But Susan and Cecil Creasy have come up with the idea of baseball-type cards for croquet players, and Brian has started to make a few of those. critical distance is a statistic we could put on the back of that baseball card. And croquet could become like baseball, dominated by statistical analysis. If you and I get to a critical distance of 13 yards, we're very happy. These guys, it's 20 or 25. The statistical analysis is like quantum mechanics, though. It only gives you probabilities. It can't tell you what's going to happen on any given shot. Because yellow is an easy scoring position, I'm guessing he's intentionally hitting black on the right side so that red goes down toward hoop eight, maybe even legally offsides. Would have been nice. you and I see a hoop scored. These guys see a two-hoop opportunity missed.
Thank you.
Notice Matthew heading south just in case. He was hoping to jaws it so he would still be in control. It's weird how scoring a hoop can potentially lose you the game. And if Red had a better hoop shot there, I'll bet Matthew would have tried to advance blue with black. So Sharif takes game one, 7-5. Matthew lost, so he gets to start game two with either blue or black. They tend just to play the next ball in order. There's no real reason to go changing that in singles. Now in doubles, if one of the players is better at this setup shot, then you might want to switch the order.
Thank you.
We talk about stop shots in golf croquet all the time, but you'll notice that Matthew's not going to use a stop shot. I think it's better described as a stun shot. It's a standard drive shot, which preserves accuracy and lets you hit his center ball. If you use a stop shot mechanism, it is inherently less accurate. And see how black rolled 3 feet. That's it. That's what he wanted. He wanted red closer to black to prevent the jump shot. Cuddle or a snuggle, take your pick. I was so sure he had made that. It wasn't until the end of the game that I realized he didn't. I had to redo a whole game's worth of scoreboards. Thank you. scoreboard's interesting. Matthew started this game with black. He served first, if you will. Cherie broke serve by making hoop one with yellow. And all he's had to do is hold serve since then. If he keeps doing that, he's going to win. Matthew's going to have to make two hoops in a row to get ahead.
Unfortunate. Completely hopped right over the center.
What he said. Cherie meant to hit black with red to the right of center, so red will be where black is, and black would be down south somewhere. And what they were really talking about was black jumping over blue, which Cherie was trying to clear. The other Abdelwahab, I think Cherie's brother, pointed that out in the comments.
You see that? Pretty off, yeah. You see that? He went for the combo and the ball he hit jumped over the ball he was trying to combo. It was dead center. Just hopped over the head, or hopped over the center.
He wanted to go farther, but he got his two in a row. If he wants to get red any distance down long, he's going to risk a double tap here. A crush too, I suppose, but crushes are pretty rare. Thank you. That could lose him the game. So Matthew evens the score, and here comes the rubber match for the 2023 USCA Golf Croquet National Singles Championship. Thank you. Black probably can't clear yellow, but he hopes to move it enough that he lessens his chance of a two-hoop situation. Thank you. I would guess he's not clearing blue because it would be to the short side and it wouldn't make its shot on red that much harder. Rather than setting up, he's going to wire himself from the opponent balls, something you don't see much in golf croquet. It's used a lot in two-ball games in AC and American rules. Little cat and mouse. Is he going to block blue? Is he going to clear it? Is he going to snuggle or is he going to go in the jaws? None of the above. He goes where blue can only clear him short. He's probably shooting the hoop here, but he also knows if he clears black, it's going to be on the left side, which gives black a lot longer shot at hoop nine than yellow. When you make an even-numbered hoop or an odd-numbered hoop by just a few feet, it gives the other player a little bit of an advantage because they get to the next hoop first. That's why it tends to alternate. But these guys clear so aggressively and so well that these runs of multiple consecutive hoops are not that unusual. This is one of the more important shots of the game. Gets a massive clearance on blue, but look where yellow goes. And you can be sure that was intentional. So yellow's legally offsides down there, hoop 10, and if he can make 9 with red, he has a big advantage. And now yellow's position is all that much more important. Trying to nudge blue into position to shoot the hoop and or clear red. So with a nice little in-off at hoop 11, Sharif takes down the defending national and world champion, Matthew Essick. 2-1 to win his 5th national championship in singles golf croquet. The first was in 2002. And now the award ceremony.
The 2023, the championship doubles, the finalists, woo! The winners, Matthew and Sharif.
Yay!
Come on, Damon.
We've got half of the winners of the doubles here. Tom hit the road. Blake Fields.
This is Blake's 3rd doubles championship, and he's still 3 weeks shy of his 17th birthday.
We got it all in. Matthew, finalist in the championship singles. And Sharif knocking on the door after last year is here with the winning prize this year.
Hold it.
Might be a bit smaller than that. We don't have this.
The size does it matter.
Hogging the hardware, those two.
All right. Yeah, while everyone's coming in, I'd like to make a special thank you to everyone with the Chesapeake Club. Thank you very much. And that's great time. Thank you.
We'd like to thank the tournament director.
I want one more picture with all the winners of it.
So give us a like, subscribe, hit that notification bell. There'll be more coming from the Golf Croquet Nationals intermittently. We got a bunch of other tournaments to do. Thanks again to our sponsors, the USCA, Chris Barley, and of course, the Croquet Store by Oakley Woods, where you can get everything you need to get from beginner to world champion.